Welcome back. We want to take you to this time last week when we were watching a tornado in Dodge City, Kansas. It's brought to you by Kelly Williamson, and this thing was a beast. You can see the debris at the surface, the dirt being kicked up. This one eventually was rated an EF4, I believe, right? Wasn't this the one that they said at least at times had EF4 damage? You know, they went out there. Luckily, it was pretty open country, so the good news was there was only a few structures that were damaged. No deaths out of this one, so we always love to see that. Of course, you don't want to see the damage, but when nobody's harmed, that is always good news. But it was an active week last week, and western Texas, or Kansas, was one of those hot spots. And here's some more tornado damage.
Yeah, this was outside of Ness City, Kansas. This is a very near Dodge City. This is also from our storm tracker, Kelly Williamson, out there. This is the after effect of what happens with that tornado. But we know in severe weather situations like that, they can be very stressful for folks that have to go through them. Even for those of us that maybe watch it on TV, it can be a very anxious time.
Yeah, Dr. Josh Klepo is a clinical psychologist and an associate professor of at the University of Alabama, Birmingham. You know, so something as simple, as Mike said, as looking at the TV can really incite a lot of anxiety in folks.
It absolutely can. You know, we don't think so, but when you think about how vivid the images are, how vivid the video is, it can impact us at a level that really catches us off guard, because we think, you know, it's not really happening to us. But a lot of times our mind and our emotions grab a hold of those images, and it creates a lot of anxiety that people don't see coming.
Is it a situation where we fear that that's going to happen to us then? And then it just, you know, what is it about that moment that makes that reaction in us?
So the good news is we do have natural fears of disasters, right? So when we see a tornado at a very deep level, we know that's not a good thing. And so while mentally, intellectually, we can say it's not happening, emotionally that connection is created sometimes. And the result are things like anxiety, problems sleeping, nightmares, all of that just by watching the images. Doesn't happen to everybody, mm-hmm. but it absolutely can happen.
So where do we go next if we identify that in ourselves? What can we do to help to mitigate or at least alleviate some of that anxiety?
Well, it's so easy. Yeah, the Weather Channel programming is so compelling, and it's important, and we have to watch it. But sometimes we just got to catch ourselves. And what I mean by that is if we're feeling that anxiety, if we're having a hard time sleeping, taking a little bit of a time out from watching and engaging in things that keep us relaxed. So hobbies, exercise, daily routine, that kind of stuff. But we also need to do some what I call self-talk, explaining to ourselves, even as silly as that may sound, this is not near me, I'm prepared, this is not happening, because as silly as that sounds, it's a reminder emotionally to, if you will, disconnect a little bit.
When it comes to our children, they can have that same reaction, but I feel like you have to treat them a little bit differently, because they don't understand like adults understand.
That's exactly it. And I think one of the most important things you can do for kids is give them perspective. They may not understand, where is this happening? How far away is it from me? What do I have in place to keep me safe? So answering questions, giving them perspective, and you've heard me say this before, more than anything else, letting them see in your eyes that you are not afraid, that you are okay. When you put those two things together, what it does for kids is it gives them a reality check and allows them to understand that as scary as the images are, that I don't necessarily need to be afraid, and not be afraid to filter what your kids are watching.
Yeah, that's a good idea, because sometimes you let them get so engrossed. Mm-hmm. You know, if a kid has a natural interest in weather, they might go, oh, I want to watch and read, and then it can kind of turn a little detrimental.
Reality TV can have, you know, a real harming effect on us psychologically. Dr. Josh Klepo, great to talk to you. Always excellent advice and something to keep in mind as we continue through severe season.